كل سنة وإحنا طيبين ومصر كلها طيبة بمناسبة شهر رمضان. وإحنا يمكن الجمعية المصرية لأمراض القلب دايما متعودة إنها تقوم بنشاط في شهر رمضان، وإحنا بنعتبر إن ده جزء هام جدا من النشاط العلمي لجمعية القلب المصرية. دكتورة جميلة نصر، أستاذ أمراض القلب جامعة قناة السويس، وأمين عام جمعية القلب المصرية، ورئيس شعبة الوقاية للجمعية المصرية لأمراض القلب. النهاردة الحقيقة أنا لي الشرف إن بدي محاضرة بعنوان Cardiac Risk in Egyptian Patients Is it Preventable؟ طبعا احنا we are proud ان احنا نقول Egyptian Society of Cardiology is one of the oldest in the Middle East, having been established in the year 1951 and has a mission for the prevention of cardiovascular disease. We have a membership of over 3,500 cardiologists with approximately 500 female. World status of cardiovascular disease, it represents 30% of all deaths worldwide. Of course, we know that it is the leading cause of death and disability. Also, the cardiovascular burden increases in developing countries. Also, there is an increase in risk factors worldwide. We have rheumatic heart disease, and we have deaths from all over the world for rheumatic fever and rheumatic heart disease, though it is declining across the years. But also regarding the ischemic heart disease by geographic region, it is noted that Egypt is one of the highest risk zones all over the world. Egypt is the world's mother. Actually, this is the oldest patient known to have coronary artery disease. It's an ancient Egyptian princess. What about the age demographics in Egypt? As we know that now we are in this year, by the year 2050, we'll have more patients aged personality, so we should have take care of the geriatric population of the Egyptians. However, the total life expectancy at birth is 73.2. And of course, we know that the non-communicable diseases, including the cardiovascular disease, diabetes, cancer, and the chronic respiratory diseases, are currently the leading national cause of death. Non-communicable diseases are estimated to account for 82% of all deaths in Egypt and 67% of premature deaths. We have the dual burden of disease, and as we all know that ischemic heart disease was the leading cause of death, killing thousands and thousands of people. There is no change in the rank. It's always number one in male and female as the number one cause of deaths and mortality. What about the proportional mortality, percent of total deaths, all ages, both sex? Of course, non-communicable diseases are estimated to account for 85% of total deaths. And we know that the cardiovascular disease represents 46% of causes of deaths of all mortality. What about Egypt rank for coronary heart disease? That's number 23, the world rank of Egypt for coronary artery disease. And actually, the deaths rated from the cardiovascular disease in selected country in Egypt, in Africa and Middle East, it's very well shown that ischemic heart disease is a real burden for Egypt, as it causes a lot of deaths per 100,000 from all causes shown. And the prevalence actually of coronary artery disease is of 8.3%. This is another. The prevalence of coronary artery disease was somewhat higher in women relative to men, 8.9 to 8.8%. This is in the Egyptian National Hypertension Project, as we recognized. Another paper which has shown that it's screening for diabetes and cardiovascular risk factors among Egyptian population along many, many years, and it showed this, I had the honor to be one of the authors for that, and it showed that the screening for Egyptian population for risk factors for diabetes, around 20% of the population seen was having the metabolic syndrome according to the IDF criteria. And this is, of course, is not very low. Another very important study for the WHO, the STEPS 2011 to 2012, and it showed that the fact sheet for the STEPS, the summary of combined risk factors for Egyptian, we have real facts for that. Currently, daily smokers, less than 5 servings of fruit and vegetables a day, low level of activity, the overweight, the raised blood pressure, currently on medication for raised blood pressure. What about the presence of 3 or more of the above risk factors, above from age 25 to 44 years for both sexes, it was around 42%. The percentage with 3 or more of the above risk factors, 79%, whereas 3 or more, it was 51% from the ages 25 to 64 years. So as long as that we have an aged population, there are more percentage of more risk factors. What about the risk factors prevalence according to the stepwise? It was found that the current tobacco smoking is a real threat. 46% of those of men had current tobacco smoking, whereas 41% percentage so had obesity. So as we can see that current tobacco smoking was a real threat mainly in male, and obesity was a real threat in females. And as we can see, this is very important to see. Egypt is one of the highest countries for having the 20 diabetes. As we know that Egypt is number 7, maybe over the world for having diabetes as well. One of the fattest country. It is even the fattest country in Africa, for as we know. Is it important to think of a smoking cessation? A smoking cessation in patients with cardiovascular disease reduces the risk of death by 36% and reduces the risk of future cardiac events by 50%. Can we compare it with the standard treatment given to the patient, which reduces the risk of death in patients of cardiovascular disease? Actually, we look for that the aspirin decreases the burden by 15%, whereas the beta blocker 23%, ACE inhibitor 23%, statins 29 to 35%. So actually, it's very important to stop smoking and advise your patients to stop smoking. As can you see, this is very amazing, figure and show that this is the projected tobacco caused mortality pattern. If you have prevention effect, actually, you will change the curve. You will change the life of the patient. Also, the trends in total cigarette consumption by the WHO, Eastern Mediterranean, in comparison with America regions, we can see that in America regions, it's declining, whereas in the Eastern Mediterranean area, it's increasing. This is very alarming. What about, we are talking about treating tobacco. Treating tobacco is a gold standard treatment. So if you are giving in statins, you prevent 1 death over 5 years. Given aspirin, you prevent 1 MI over 5 years. Given antihypertensive, you prevent therapy. You prevent 1 stroke, 1 MI over 1 year. But actually, if you stop smoking, you'll ask the patient, actually, you would prevent 1 premature death, plus cessation medication, you prevent 1 premature death. Behavioral support again, and of course, all of these cases, the number needed to treat is much less. This is very important to tackle. What about, I'll tell you something, what about the patient, if he's going to get this advice from non-clinician, actually not respond very well, but if he's a clinician, interfere with that and give this advice to stop smoking by clinician, actually, this will make a difference. What about if three or more clinicians are giving this advice? The number of clinicians can make a difference too. So compared to smokers who receive assistance from no clinician, smokers who receive assistance from two or more clinicians are 2.5 to 2.5 times likely to quit successfully. The second risk factor, very important, the prevalence of low-risk activity, physical activity in selected Arab countries. Actually, unfortunately, Egypt is one of those having low physical activity in comparison with other Arab countries. Do you really think we have a chance without exercise? We are prone to obesity, we are prone to many, many coronary heart disease, diabetes, hypertension, cancer, depression, arthritis, etc. So no, we should really look for exercise. This is very important. We should keep on asking the patient to do exercise. As actually, when we are exercising, we're preventing more than 20 chronic diseases. This is very important. We have to get to people moving. They should be regularly active. They should be engaged in active, healthy lifestyle. And exercise, of course, is medicine. Your prescription for health is that exercise is for medicine. Why loss of weight is the most important? Because if you have low waist measurement, improves everything. You improve the lipid profile, the insulin sensitivity, the susceptibility to thrombosis, inflammation markers, endothelial function, even the risk of coronary artery disease. This is very important to look for, especially that for the visceral adipose tissue, which is with the high waist measurement. What about, according to the AHA, what about the nutrition? Actually, it's stated that if you have taken, you ask your patient to have ample amount of vegetables, fruits, and whole grains with the low-fat dairy products, fish, poultry, and legumes, and decrease the saturated fatty acids, the trans fatty acids, the tropical oils, the sweets, sugar, sweetened beverage, and as well. This is a very important figure. It denotes how we can change from the healthy behavior to subclinical disease, and then to clinical disease, the potential benefit. That's why we should promote health. We should look for the lifestyle change, which is called now lifestyle medicine. And this is very important. And it has, of course, clinical application, the concept of risk. As we know, it increases actually if asymptomatic, from asymptomatic plus risk factor, diabetic. This is very important, and we have to, the era of specialized medicine. Three options for preventing cardiovascular disease in asymptomatic individuals. Should we wait until the patient has had a cardiovascular event? Should we wait until the patient had signs of atherosclerosis? But in that stage, we require expensive imaging procedures. Or should we treat factors that lead to an increased lifetime risk of cardiovascular disease? We are coming in an era of many, many futures in robotics and intervention cardiology, the digital doctor, the digital nurse, the portable echo, the non-invasive FFR. But actually, we should go back. The role of cardiologists is for education of other healthcare personnel to advocate for healthy public policies to treat the individual patients. And this is very important. Do we need a change? We have to have a preventive-based strategy. Prevention actually establish a culture of healthy living. And this is according to the sustainable goals of development and according to the طبعا من اهم الاستراتيجيات لوزاره التعليم العالي والبحث العلمي ان احنا يبقى في تطوير المحور الثالث الصحه تطوير سياسات الصحيه ومن ضمنها الحقيقه الاهتمام بالوعي الصحي والمنظومه الصحيه والرياضه وغيره. According to the guidelines, very quickly, in the primary prevention of cardiovascular disease executive summary, most important way to prevent atherosclerosis is to promote healthy lifestyle. Lifestyle. Next, we need a team-based care. Very important for prevention. Third, those for 40 to 70 years of age are being evaluated for risk prevention and should undergo a 10-year atherosclerotic cardiovascular disease risk estimation. And according to this estimation, we could tackle the problem very energetically. Also, healthy diet. healthy diet, intake of fruits, vegetables, nuts, whole grains, lean vegetables, as we say, and decrease the intake of trans fats. Message number five, they should engage at least 150 minutes per week of accumulated moderate intensity physical activity, or 75 minutes per week of vigorous intensity physical activity. Those with diabetes, we have the message number six, lifestyle. It's very important, it's crucial. And of course, in this kind of medication is indicated, we can use metformin and other newer drugs. Message number seven should be assessed for healthcare visit for tobacco use. Stop smoking. Aspirin should be used infrequently in the routine primary prevention. And statin is the first line therapy for prevention in those with LDL more than 190 milligram per DL with diabetes, 40 to 7, those determined to be at sufficient risk. Non-pharmacological intervention is recommended, of course, of all having hypertension or should lack. So the era of COVID-19, take care of yourself, dear cardiologist. Take care that you protect yourself when you are doing imaging, we're in the cath lab, in your hospital, in the outpatient clinic. And remember that healthcare system, it's an iceberg phenomena. Self-care prevents 80% of the problem. And then this, there will be no professional care. We will not need primary or tertiary intervention or secondary. So the first wealth is health. To conclude, the aging trends of heart disease are common in our country, even among the younger population. We have very high percentage of smokers. This is very alarming. We have interesting factor is the high percentage in young patients. Heart failure is an epidemic disease. Many cardiovascular diseases lead to heart failure. Actually, this, of course, lead to hospitalization and a lot of cost. Main challenge is the early diagnosis. And this will take to cover, many, many out-of-pocket costs. And this is very important, cost of drugs and the medicine. Oh, of course, we know that the government is making efforts to have all the drugs needed for cardiovascular disease. So this is another challenge that prevention is really an important item. Egypt is undergoing an epidemiological transition. Egypt has a high prevalence of cardiovascular disease, including tobacco and obesity. We have younger patients. Prevention is the management. Cardiologists should lead in prevention, educate, advocate, treat. And this is my preferred slide because it's for the European Society of Cardiology. Very nice equation to tell it to every patient you have, even in life, to change the lifestyle of any Egyptian. 0351405300. People who stay healthy tend to have certain characteristics. 0 stands for no tobacco. 3 walk 3 kilometers daily or 30 minutes any moderate activity. Take 5 portions of fruit and vegetables a day. Blood pressure should be less than 140 millimeter mercury. 5 total cholesterol less than 5 millimole per liter. 3 LDL less than 3 millimole per liter. 0 avoidance of overweight and diabetes. Fortunately, we can prevent mortality related to cardiovascular disease by having patient awareness, education, workshop, as we have known that. And actually, this is my last slide about Maslow's hierarchy of needs. Of course, our country needs a lot of work. So actually, we have to be able to personally growth ourselves, to achieve, to be responsible. And then, of course, you will gain a lot, and Egypt will gain a lot from our dear doctors all over. Thank you very much.